guys, time for Hot Topics. Let's do it. Hi guys, so today I want to share another story with you. Today I want to talk about the K. Michelle and Lyrica beef intensifying and why I think K. Michelle is an unpredictable basket case. A basket case that needs to be locked away in someone's psych ward, but how I respect the things that she's saying and doing in this in-depth interview. I mean, my mom used to always say, nut jobs can do good deeds too. I didn't believe her until I seen this K. Michelle storyline. But first, let's quickly refresh our memories. So we all know that Basket Case got into an argument with A1. And by the way, when I say Basket Case, I'm referring to K. Michelle in a loving way. It's a positive thing. So don't get all in a tizzy. It just means my feeling on K. Michelle go back and forth on a daily basis. I'm not sure if I like this chick or if I don't. So until I pick a side, I'm gonna lovingly refer to her as Basket Case. So they both got into an argument. Basket Case said some mean things like his wife can't sing and she's unprofessional. And A1 said some things like, that's why your music career is falling off. You're banned from radio and no one likes working with you, okay? And today, A1 and Lyrica posted postings to their social media contradicting K. Michelle's statements that Lyrica was unprofessional and couldn't sing. The postings actually showed Basket Case praising Lyrica, totally contradicting herself. Now, because I haven't picked a side yet, I'm gonna say some very neutral things. Is it true that no one wants to work with Basket Case? Well, I mean, she has a few enemies. If you want to include people like Tamar Braxton, Nicki Minaj, Memphis, Toya Wright, Jocelyn Hernandez, Jonathan Fernandez, and Angela Yee. I mean, do you consider that no one wants to work with her? I mean, it depends on how you look at it. I've known people with longer lists than that. I can't name who they are, but I'm sure they're out there. I mean, was she really banned from radio? No, not really. She was banned from one station, and that's Radio 1. But they are responsible for 55% of the market. I mean, it depends on how you want to look at it. I mean, there's still another 45% of the market still left. It depends on how you want to look at it. I mean, did her last album flop? It depends on if you're a numbers person. I mean, it did debut at number 56 when her other ones debuted at number 2, 6, and 2. But, you know, these are all picky, minute things. But I will get personal with it. I haven't cut Basket Case off completely yet. I think that her personality comes with a lot of mouth, but it's good and bad things. Like when she's acting negative, you just want to give her a tall glass of shut the hell up. But this new positive thing that she's doing, I really admire. She is actually opening up and talking out loud about what she's gone through with these butt injections. You know, she wanted a butt as big as a globe, okay? And she's not the only one. It's the new fad. I mean, these women are getting these butt injections just left and right on a daily basis. And K. Michelle, brave enough to say, hey, there might be a downside to this, people. Look what I went through.
I started to just always be tired and just drained and just like unmotivated, and I'm really motivated, and it just started to get hard to even like get up out of bed without like my legs getting adapted to it, just things like that. And then finally I just started to, it said I had lupus. So I was like, okay, this explains everything. And then the second panel came back and said I didn't have lupus. So for me, I was like relieved, but not, because then I still didn't know what was wrong with me. So I knew I didn't have everything else. And I'm just like, okay, what is going on? So I started to read about, I thought maybe this is it, you know, because it's not supposed to be in there. You know, it's a foreign object. I started to read and I started to see that so many women were having like the same symptoms that I was having. And I started to look and look and look. And then I had to have an MRI. And the MRI showed these foreign objects, you know.
Those pellets.
The pellets, like where they were and everything. So the first step was to do. I recently just did Dr. Oz. And you can watch that surgery actually online somewhere now. It
where
just
they
aired.
Took, to pull some out.
Yeah, and you know, me and him, we were trying to talk a girl out of doing it as well, because in my DMs, I have right now probably about 15 girls who are crying and can't walk.
Wow, to be so open and honest about something that you're suffering from when most people try to hide when things aren't going right in their life, and then come to find out, this is why she couldn't make the radio gig that day. She was not feeling well, people. So what I want to know is, do you guys think K. Michelle should just shut up on a permanent basis, or is she a complete package and you have to accept her with the good and the bad? Me personally, I'm not so sure where I stand with K. Michelle just yet. That's why I want you guys to think. Also, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and the notification button for more stories like these. Until next time, talk to you then. Bye.